Our contract could bind us to a club for life. Most people called it the slavery contract. We had virtually no rights at all.
In 1959, George Easton refused to sign a new contract with Newcastle United. The reason? Lousy housing, a horrible second job, and the club did not allow him to tour with England's under-23 team. Instead of signing, Easton required a transfer. Newcastle refused. Now, the club could legally keep him under contract forever. Unhappy, underpaid, and unable to move, Easton went on strike for half a year before Newcastle relented and sold him.
People in business or teaching were able to hand in their notice and move on. We weren't. That was wrong.
In 1963, Easton took the club to the High Court. Arguing an unfair restraint of trade, Easton reformed the British transfer market. A challenge much like Curt Flood started about 5 years later for the reverse clause in baseball. In Flood versus Kuhn. Today, the football industry developed a system to regulate and manage employment through a global transfer system. This system continues to restrict some basic employment rights that are common in any other industry. George Easton fought to provide the freedom to seek the best possible job. A freedom workers in any industry acquired long before football players. This achievement is instrumental in shaping a fair market, creating opportunities players enjoy today, and allowing the game to thrive.